icon series.
So let us recall some important points up to now we have discussed in the chapter. So the main points, that is the main key points in this chapter are, so there are different types of plants and there are different parts in a plant. So there are different parts. So different parts in a plant. So the different parts are the roots and stem, and third one is leaves, and fourth one flower and fruit. So these are the some important parts of the plant, and roots will give support and hold the plant firmly in the soil, and roots will absorb the water from the soil and supplies to all parts of the plant. And there are two types of roots, and the first type is tap root and the second one is fibrous root. So there are two types of root system, so tap root and fibrous root. So in tap root there will be a main root and another thin roots will grow from the main root. Example, rose, hibiscus and mustard. So these are the plants examples for the tap roots. And fibrous roots, in the fibrous roots there will not be a main root and a large number of tiny roots will be attached at the middle of the stem. So they are look like a bunch of roots will attached at the bottom of the stem. So that type of roots are called fibrous roots. An example, grass. So grass plants have fibrous roots. And children, the next one is stem. So the part which grows above the ground is called stem, and the stem is different for different types of trees, plants. So in some plants the stem is very strong and woody, that is called trunk, and in some plants the stem is thin but strong and woody, and in other some plants the stem is soft and weak. That means in trees the stem is very strong and thick, it is called trunk, whereas in shrubs the stem is very thin and strong, whereas in herbs the stem is soft and weak, and it is present in green color. Next, this stem gives support for the plant and it supplies the water to every part of the plant, and also it supplies food every part of the plant. And some plants will store food in the stem. Examples, potato, and some are ginger, are the examples for the plants which stores food in their stems. And another one is leaves. So leaf is the most important part in the plant, because they will prepare food for the plant. How they prepare food? By the process photosynthesis. So what is photosynthesis? So these leaves will mix the water and minerals and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, and in the presence of sunlight the leaves will prepare food. That food is called one type of sugar, that is called glucose. And in the photosynthesis process the leaves will give off oxygen, which will be very useful to all living beings, without which the living beings cannot survive. Next, another one is flower. There are different types of flowers and different colored flowers. So they are looking very beautiful. They will attract insects for pollination, and fertilization takes place in flowers. These flowers will be developed into fruits. So the flowers are the main site of reproduction, and the pollination takes place in the flowers. They will be converted into fruits. So this is about flowers. Another one is fruits. So the flowers will be converted into fruits. Why? Because after reproduction, that is after fertilization by the insects, the flowers will be converted into fruits. We will get different types of fruits in the form of vegetables, in the form of seasonal fruits. And another one is seeds. So seeds also the part of the plant. So we will get a new plant from the seeds. That means if you give air, water and warmth for the seeds will grow into a new plant, and the new plant will become a large plant, and this process is called seed germination. So children, so this is about the second chapter. So this is the end of this chapter. The next topic will be continued in the next episode. Okay, thank you.
Dear children, we have different parts in our body to do different kinds of works. Like this, the plants and the trees also have different parts to do different kinds of works. For example, the leaves of the trees and plants prepare food for the plant and so on. So, let us learn about the different parts of the trees and their uses. Let us find out more about parts of a plant. We see plants all around us. They are of different sizes and shapes. Plants having tall and woody stems are called trees. Some plants are small. They have soft green stems. They are called herbs. Some bushy plants have woody stems and branches. They are called shrubs. The part of the plant which holds it in the soil is called the root. The part of the plant which is above the soil is called the shoot. The shoot has stem, branches, leaves, buds, flowers, thorns, and fruits. Do you know the bamboo plant can grow up to 48 centimeter in one day? The root. There are two kinds of roots: tap root, fibrous root. Tap root. There is a main root. Several thin roots grow from the main root. Such roots are called tap root. Balsam, hibiscus, bean, and mustard have tap roots. Fibrous roots. There is no main root. It has a number of tiny roots attached to the end of the stem. It looks like a bunch of roots. These are called fibrous roots. Example, grass. The main functions of root. It holds the plant firmly in the soil. It takes water and mineral salts from the soil and sends them to other parts of the plant through the stem. Some roots store food. Vegetables such as carrot and radish are roots with food stored in them. The stem. The stem of a plant grows above the ground. It holds the plant upright. It also supports the branches and leaves. Different plants have different kinds of stems. The stem of a banyan tree or coconut tree is thick, hard, and woody. It is called a trunk. A money plant has soft and weak stem. A rose plant has short, woody stem, which is strong and hard. The main functions of a stem. The stem gives support to the plant. It holds the plant upright. It carries water to the leaves. It also carries the food prepared by leaves to all parts of the plant. In some plants, the stem stores food. Vegetables such as ginger and potato are stems that store food. They grow underground. The stem of sugarcane stores sugar and water. The leaf. Leaves are of different shapes and sizes. Some are long and narrow. Some are big and broad, while some are round and some are small. Even their margins differ. Some are straight, while some are uneven. However, most leaves are green in color. Do you know? Leaves contain a green pigment, chlorophyll, which helps them to make food. Parts of the leaf. The flat and broad part of a leaf is called lamina. Through the middle of leaf runs a thin tube that divides it into two parts. This tube is called the main vein. A lot of small veins arise from the main vein, forming a network of veins. These veins are called side veins or venules. The stalk of the leaf is called petiole. The surface of a leaf has tiny pores called stomata. The leaf breathes in and out through the stomata. The main function of a leaf. Leaves prepare food for the plant. Stomata are present in leaves for the exchange of gases. Leaves store extra food, as in cabbage, lettuce, spinach, etc. Do you know? Some parts of a croton leaf are not green. These parts cannot make food as they do not have chlorophyll. Flowers. The flower is the brightest part of a plant. Flowers are of different shapes, sizes, and colors. Most of the flowers have a pleasant smell. Flowers look beautiful. They grow at the tip of the main part called stalk. The sepals protect the flower when it is a bud. Just inside the sepals are petals. The petals attract insects and birds. The main function of a flower. Flower is the site of reproduction in plants. They attract insects for pollination. Fruits. A flower develops into a fruit. The petals fall and the lower part of the flower gets swollen into a fruit. When a fruit becomes ripe, it changes its color. Some fruits are big and some are small. Example, big fruit, jackfruit. Small fruit, grape. Most of the vegetables and fruits that we eat are the fruits of plants. Beans, peas, tomatoes, brinjal, etc. are some fruits we eat. The main functions of fruits. Fruits have seeds inside. The seeds grow into new plants. Seed is the future plant. Do you know banana and pineapple have no seeds? Seeds. Fruits have seeds inside them. Some fruits have only one seed. Example, mango. Some have many seeds inside them. Example, watermelon. Seeds grow into new plants. Each seed has a baby plant inside. The baby plant begins to grow when the seeds fall on the ground and gets air, water, and warmth. The growth of a new plant from a seed is called germination. Say aloud, woody, branches, hibiscus, fibrous, support, underground. Key ideas: roots, stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits are parts of a plant. There are two types of roots: taproot and fibrous root. Green plants make their own food. Fruits have seeds inside them. Plants help us in many ways. Each seed has a baby plant.
So children, so these are the some functions, some uses of roots. So generally, so roots are the parts which grow below the soil and it will give supports for the plant. And these roots will hold the plant firmly in the soil. And the second one is roots take in water and minerals and send to all parts of the plant. So children, leaves prepare their food. So for preparing food, water also required. So here the water will be supplied to the plant with the help of roots. Here roots absorbs the water from the soil and supplied that water through the stem through all parts of the plant like leaves, branches, stem, etc. So that's why roots take in water and minerals and send it to all parts of the plant. Next third one is some roots store food also. Children, some roots store food also. For example, carrot, radish are examples for the roots. Because they are nothing but roots and they are taken as food. Because those store their food in their roots. That's why they become very thick and we will eat them as a food. So, this is because some plants store their food in the roots. So, children, this is the about functions of the roots. The first one is, it holds the plant to the soil without fell down and give support to the plants. And second one is, roots will absorb water from the soil, water and minerals from the soil and supply this water and mineral to all parts of the plant. And also some roots store their food in them. Example, carrot and radish and also beetroot. So we can eat the roots of the some plants as a food. So children, so this is the first question and answer. Note down this question and answer in your notebook. So see the next question. The second question is, name the two kinds of roots. Name the two kinds of roots. So children, we have all discussed in the chapter, there are two types of roots. So see the answer for this question. So answer for the second question is, children, there are two types of roots. So the first one is the tap root and the second one is the fibrous roots. So these are the two kinds of the roots. So we have already discussed two types of roots, the tap root. So in the tap root, there is a main root and some small thin roots will grow from the main root. So this type of structure is called taproot. Whereas in fibrous root, there will be no main root
and a lot of thin roots will be attached to the bottom of the stem. That means a bunch of small thin roots will be attached to the bottom of the stem. So this type of structured roots are called fibrous roots. So most of the plants like rose, hibiscus, mustard, banyan tree, mango tree, all types of most of the trees contain tap roots. And fibrous roots, the examples for the fibrous roots are grass trees, especially food grain plants have fibrous roots like rice, wheat, maize, etc. So this is about different types of roots. There are particularly two types of roots. The first one is the tap root. Example for the tap roots are most of all the trees have tap root, mustard tree and also mango tree, banyan tree, hibiscus tree, rose tree. And the second one is fibrous root. The example for the fibrous root are grass plants, especially food grain plants have fibrous roots like maize, rice, wheat, etc. So children, these are the two kinds of the roots. Note down this question answer in your notebook. So go to the next question. And the third question is, why is a leaf important to plants? Why is a leaf important to plants? So children, see the answer for this question. The answer is, leaves prepare food for the plants. And second one, stomata presents in leaves exchange gases and sends out water vapor. So children, so leaf is a very, very important part in the plant because it prepares food required for the plant. So by using water, minerals and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, the leaves will prepare their food. That is, the leaves will mix this water, minerals and carbon dioxide. In the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, it prepares food for the plants. And this process is called photosynthesis. So by using the process photosynthesis, leaves prepare food required for the plants. And second one is, leaves have small pores on their surfaces called stomata. So the stomata are nothing but like sweat glands of our skin. So the stomata presents in leaves and they will helpful in the exchange of gases. So because during photosynthesis, leaves required carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere will enter into the plant through this stomata. That means leaves breathe in carbon dioxide through stomata required for the photosynthesis and also sends out water vapor through the stomata. So the excess water produced in the photosynthesis in the plant will be sent out through the stomata. This process is called respiration. So this stomata very helpful in the exchange of gases. So particularly leaves require carbon dioxide. That's why they breathe in carbon dioxide to stomata, and during photosynthesis, oxygen will be come out and this oxygen will be sent out through this stomata. So the send out oxygen is very helpful for the living organisms on the earth. So the exchange of gases will take place through stomata. So these are the importance of the leaves. So note down this in your notebook. See the next question. Children, the fourth question is, how do seeds grow into new plants? How do seeds grow into new plants? Children, see the answer. The answer have three points mainly. The first point is, each seed has a baby plant inside. And the second one is, the seeds fall on the ground and gets air, water and warm. And third point is, then baby plant begins to grow into a new plant. So children, so these are the three steps. So particularly the seed is a non-living thing and the seed contains a small baby plant called embryo, and actually it does not have life. And if the seed is supplied air, water and warmth, then the water enters into the seed, then the baby plant gets life and it will grows into a small plant. So if the seed falls on the ground and it will go into the ground and it will gets air and water and warmth, when water enters the seed, the baby plant gets life and it will grow into a small plant, and a small plant will come out from the seed. And the third one is the baby plant begins to grow into a new plant. So the baby plant day by day increases in size and becomes a big plant and a new plant. So this is about seed germination. So this total process of a seed grown into a new plant and a new plant grown into a big plant, and this total process is called seed germination. So children, so this is the process how seeds grow into new plant. So note down this question and answer in your notebook. See the next question. So fifth question. What are the main functions of a flower? So children, what are the main functions of a flower? See the answer for this question. The answer for this question is, flower is the site of reproduction in plants. And the second one is, they attract insects for pollination. So children, flower is the site of reproduction in plants. So children, so flower is another important part in the plant, because reproduction will takes place in the plants, in the flower only. That means, so the flowers will convert into fruits by the process of pollination. So flowers attracts insects for pollination. So when insects fall on the flowers, the pollination will takes place, and then fertilization takes place. And the fertilization takes place, the flower gradually converted into the fruit. So that's why flowers are very important for producing fruits. So that's why flowers are very different colors, and they produce pleasant smells. So because of their different colors and because of their pleasant smells, the insects will be attracted by them. And when insects fall on them, the pollination will take place. And because of this pollination, the fertilization will take place in the flower, and then due to this fertilization, the flowers are gradually converted into the fruit. That means the lower part of the flower will gradually swollen and becomes a fruit. So after some days, the petals of the flower will fall down and it will become into a fruit. So that's why the flower is the another important part in the plant. So note down this question and answer in your notebook. So see the next question. So the next part in our activity session is complete the sentences. Children, see the screen. You are observing 5 sentences are given, and the answers are also given below the sentences in pink colored boxes. So here the answers given are, the first one is stem, and second branches, third one is 2, fourth one is fibrous root, and fifth one is lamina. Now we have to choose the correct answer among the given answers, and we have to write that correct answer in the blanks. So read the first sentence. There are dash kinds of roots. There are dash kinds of roots. So children, so all roots are not looking same. So there are mainly 2 types of roots we have discussed in the answers and questions part. So there are different kinds of roots, especially 2 kinds of root, that is taproot and fibrous roots. So the correct answer for the first one is 2. So write 2 in the first blank. So 2 is the correct answer. So the sentence is, there are 2 kinds of roots. So children, read the second sentence. Dash has not main root. So which type of root has not main root? So children, there are mainly 2 types of roots. One is a taproot and fibrous root. Among these types of roots, one root system does not have main root. Which root system? Tap root or fibrous root? Yes, fibrous root. So fibrous root has no main root. It does not contain main root like tap root. So most of the tiny, that means large number of tiny roots will attach it to the bottom of the stem like a bunch. So the correct answer for the second sentence is fibrous root. So fibrous root has not main root. So the correct answer is fibrous root. So it does not have main root. So lot of, that means a bunch of small tiny roots attached to the bottom of the stem. So like a grass plant. Next, read the third sentence. Dash holds the plant upright. The children, among all the parts of the plant, there are different parts in the plant like roots, stem, branches, leaves, flowers, buds and fruits. Among all these parts, which part holds the plant upright? That means which part gives support for the plant from the cyclone times when there are a strong winds. Which part holds the plant upright without bending the plant? Yes, stem. So stem holds the plant upright. So the correct answer for the third sentence is stem. So write the word stem in the third line. So stem holds the plant upright. So children, read the fourth sentence. The stem gives support to the dash. So children, the stem gives support to the dash. So children, so most of the trees have more number of branches. So if there are more number of branches, then the plant may bend because of heavy weight of those branches. But the stem gives support to the branches. So the correct answer for the fourth sentence is branches. So the fourth sentence becomes the stem gives support to the branches. So generally some trees have large number of branches. So because of their weight, the tree may be bent when it grows. So that way the stem gives support to the branches and makes the plant to grow in the upright. So the fourth sentence is the stem gives support to the branches. So read the fifth sentence. The flat and broad part of the leaf is called dash. So we have already discussed different parts of the leaf. That is midrib, side veins, leaf tip, lamina and stalk. So among these parts of the leaf, so which one is flat and broad? As lamina. The flat and broad part of the leaf is called lamina. So children, so these are the correct answers for the given sentences. So note down these sentences in your notebook and read at your home. So let us enter the next part in our activity session. So the next part is name these. So children, they have given some sentences and we have to write the names of those. So the names are already given below the sentences. That is banana, mango, apple, and next one is taproot, fibrous root, and third one is potato, ginger, and fourth one is stem fruit, and fifth one is lettuce, spinach, and sixth one is chlorophyll. So children, these six are the answers for the above six sentences. Now we have to choose the correct answer and write that correct word in the blank. So read the first one. Any two parts of a plant. Any two parts of a plant. So children, among these six answers, which are the parts of a plant? Which one represents parts of a plant? Yes, stem, fruit represents parts of the plant. So write the word in the first one. Next, read the second sentence. Types of fruits. Children, we have already discussed there are two types of roots, fibrous roots and tap root. So the answer for the second sentence is tap root, fibrous root. So write the word here. Next, read the third sentence, two underground stems. So we have already discussed about the functions of the stems, that some stems store their food in them. So those are called underground stems. We can eat them stems as a food. So the examples for the underground stems are, so children, can you identify the answer for the third sentence? Yes, potato, ginger. So potato and ginger are the underground stems and we can eat them as a food because those plants store their food in their stems. Potato, ginger is the correct answer for the third one. Read the fourth sentence. three fruits we eat. So three fruits we eat. Children, we eat different types of fruits in different seasons in our daily life. So identify the fruits in the given answers. So here, which one represents fruits? Which answer represents fruits? Yes, banana, mango, apple. So these are the fruits we eat today. So the answer for the fourth sentence is banana, mango, apple. So these are the examples for three fruits. Next, read the fifth sentence. Two leaves we eat. So children, we eat different types of vegetables during our lunch and dinner. And some are vegetables and some are leafy vegetables. So can you identify the leafy vegetables among the given answers? So leafy vegetables, yes, lettuce and spinach. So lettuce and spinach are the leafy vegetables. So in these plants, those plants store their food in their leaves. So that's why those leaves can be taken as a food in our lunch. And these leafy vegetables are very rich in minerals and vitamins. That's why we have to eat at least twice a week these leafy vegetables. Next, read the sixth sentence. The pigment present in green leaves. So children, so which pigment present in green leaves? So which pigment gives green color for the leaves? Yes, chlorophyll. So chlorophyll is the pigment present in the green leaves. So because of this pigment, the leaves are getting green color. So this chlorophyll is a green color pigment present in leaves. And this role of chlorophyll causes green color for the leaves. That's why most of the leaves are in green color because of this pigment chlorophyll present in the leaves. But some leaves does not have chlorophyll. That's why some leaves will appeared in red color, yellow color, white color, etc. So this is about chlorophyll. So children, so these are the answers for the given six sentences. So note down these sentences in your notebook. So let us enter the next part in our activity section. So match the following. Children, so this is a matching. So some flowers and some parts of the plants are given on the left side and their names are given on the right side. Now our task is to match the each one with correct one. So we have to pair the correct one. So children, see the first one. So in the first one represents a flower. So flower gets from stomata, seeds, tap fibrous, backbone of the plant, bud. So which one is the correct for the first flower? So flower will get from bud. So this is the correct pair. So match the flower and bud. So means bud will grow into flower after some days. That's why we have to match those two. Next one. So children, so see the next one. So match this next one with stomata, seeds, tap fibrous, backbone of the plant, bud. So children, the second picture represents tap fibrous roots. Tap and fibrous roots, seeds, stomata, backbone of the plant. So match this with it seeds. Okay, so the correct pair is backbone of the plant. Next, third picture. See the third picture, you are observing the roots. So in the third picture, they have given roots. So that is, there are also some tap roots and fibrous roots are there. So match this with tap and fibrous. Next, children, see the fourth one. Here, the fourth picture representing a leaf. The leaf contains small pores on its surface. That small pores on its surface on the leaf are called stomata. So match this leaf with the stomata. So this is the correct pair. So stomata. Next, see the fifth picture. You are observing a fruit here. So can you identify that fruit name? Yes, it is a pomegranate. So it is a fruit. What does fruit contains? So if you cut that fruit, you will observe some red colored seeds. So every fruit gives seeds. So fruit contains seeds. So match the fruit with the seeds. So children, this is the correct pair. So this is the matching. So the first one represents a flower. Flower will get from bud. And the second one represents a stem and branches. So these are the backbone of the plant. That means they will make the plant to grow in upright, and they does not bend the plant. So that way they are called backbone of the plant. The third picture represents root system. That's why tap and fibrous root. Fourth picture represents leaves, and leaves have stomata. And the fifth one represents fruit, pomegranate fruit. And every fruit contains seeds. Fruit gives seeds. So this is the correct matching. So children, note down this matching in your notebook and practice at your house. So let us enter the next part in our activity session. Write true and false for the following sentences. Children, so read, there are 5 sentences are given. So read the every sentence. If the sentence is true, write T in the box. And if the sentence is wrong, that is false, write F in the box. So read the first sentence. There are 3 kinds of fruits. So children, is it correct? No, because there are only 2 types of fruits, tap root and fibrous root. But there are no 3 kinds of fruit. So the first sentence is wrong, that is false. So write F in the box. So see the second sentence. Shoot is underground part of the plant. So children, is it correct? No. So mainly a plant is divided into 2 parts, that is roots and shoots. So root is the part which is underground part, and shoot is the part which grows above the ground. So that's why shoot is not underground part of the plant. It will grow above the ground. So that's why the given second sentence is also wrong. That is false. Write F in the box. So read the third sentence. The stem gives support to the plant. So children, is it correct? Yes. The stem will hold the tree upright, and it will prevent the tree from bending during the strong winds and cyclone times. And also it gives support from the weight of the branches. So the third sentence is correct. That is true. Write T in the box. Next, read the fourth sentence. The sepals attract insects and birds. So children, the sepals attract insects and birds. Is it correct? No. Because sepals give protection for the flower when it is as a bud. But petals will attract the insects. So here the fourth sentence is wrong. So the petals will attract the insects and birds because the petals will present in different colors. And they give pleasant smell. So because of the smell and color of the petals, the insect and birds will be attracted. But the sepals are generally present in green color. They just give support for the plant, flower. They will present at the bottom of the flower and give support for the petals. So the fourth sentence is wrong. So write F in the box. So read the fifth sentence. The leaf breathes through the stomata. So we have already discussed about the functions of the leaf. So in the leaf, the exchange of gases takes place through the stomata. Stomata are the small pores present on the leaves of the surface of the leaves. So leaves breathe through the stomata. That means leaf breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen through the stomata. So the fifth sentence is correct. That is true. So write T in the box. So children, these are the true and false sentences. Note down these true and false sentences in your notebook and practice at your home. So let us enter the next part in the activity section. So children, look at this. It is a fun activity. And if you observe, there is a diagram of plant is given, and different parts are represented, but they give spaces. That means they give blanks in the parts. Now we have to write the correct part. We have to identify and we have to write the correct part in each box. But they have also given the parts at the below of this diagram. So the first one is flower, branch, fruit, stem, bud, root. So these are the parts of your plant. Now our task is, so we have to write the correct part in the correct blank. So see the first one. So here the first box, the first one represents, the first part represents bud. So it is not a flower, it is a bud. So write bud in the first box. So children, Now see the second box, second plant present on the left side. So it represents, so children, could you identify that? What is that? Yes, flower. So very good. So it is a flower. So write the flower in the box. So children, see the next one. So flower, and it represents, so what it represents? So it represents branches. So write a branch in the box. So children, see the next one. So some fruits are red. So that is a fruit. So write fruit in the box. And see the next one. So this thick and this thin and thick part is called stem. So write stem in the box. Children, see the part which is grown in the soil. So that is root. So write root here. So children, so these are the correct parts for the given diagram. So let us see the parts once again. The bird, fruit, stem, flower, branch and root. So these are the different parts of the plant. So children, note down these different parts of the plant in your notebook and practice the diagram of the plant in your notebook, and the diagram of this plant will be given in the PDF. So see that PDF and practice the diagram of this plant and mark the parts also in your diagram. So the activity part in this lesson is completed. Thank you. Half just.